Determine if each sequence converges or diverges. If it converges, determine what it converges to. So determine if a sequence converges or diverges. We think of a sub n as a function of n and determine the limit as n approaches infinity. If the limit exists and equals L, the sequence converges and it converges to L. If the limit doesn't exist, the sequence diverges. First, we have a sub n equals negative 2n plus 5 divided by 2 to the power of n. We need to consider the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n. Notice as n approaches infinity, negative 2 times n approaches negative infinity. And now considering 5 divided by 2 to the power of n, as n approaches infinity, the denominator increases, the numerator stays 5, and therefore the fraction or the quotient approaches 0. And therefore the limit approaches negative infinity, which is not a real number, and we say the limit does not exist. Because the limit doesn't exist, we say the sequence diverges. Let's take a look at this graphically. I've already set this up in Desmos. We will plot points on the coordinate plane in the form of n, a sub n. And now we'll plot the first 50 points. Again, the y value of each represent the terms in the sequence. And notice the y values go down or decrease without bound and approach negative infinity, which is why the sequence diverges. Let's look at the second example. We have a sub n equals 5 plus 0.25 to the power of n. Once again, we consider the limit as n approaches infinity of a sub n. To begin, notice 5 is not affected by n. We only have to consider what's happening to 0.25 to the power of n. Because the base is between 0 and 1, as you multiply by more and more factors of 0.25, the value gets smaller and smaller and approaches 0. And therefore, the limit is equal to 5 plus 0, which is 5. Because the limit exists, the sequence converges, and the sequence converges to 5. Again, let's take a look at this graphically. Again, we'll plot points on the coordinate plane in the form of n, a sub n, looking at the first 50 points. Notice the y values quickly approach positive 5, which is why the sequence converges, and we can see it converges to 5. I hope you found this helpful.